Now we're going to the more operatic singers, starting with Juan Diego Flores Santo, which was released back on October 25, 2010. Now, I have first admired Juan Diego Flores when I first heard him sing Una Furtiva Lágrima from L'Elisir d'Amore in one of the compilation CDs known as Classics 2004. And it's easy to say that he did start out as a very, very famous bel canto singer, singing the likes of Conte Alma Viva from Barbiere di Siviglia and Ramiro from La Cenerentola. But these days, he's also sung the likes of the Duke from Rigoletto and Edgardo from Lucia di Lammermoor. But it's very easy to say that this gentleman's forte definitely has to be in the Italian bel canto repertoire and even the French repertoire. Yes, he's also sung some Mozart, like he even sang Tamino's Bildnis aria, and one interpretation that I really like so much, even though some people might think that, oh, his technique is too Italian and blah blah blah, but I didn't really care. I definitely enjoyed his singing of Tamino's Dies Bildnis ist bezaubernd schön. It's definitely another Tamino aria I could definitely recommend to any hardcore Mozart fan or even hardcore tenor fan. So going to his album Santo, this basically composes of a lot of holy songs and even some tunes for the holidays as well. Most notably, Minuit Chrétien or O Holy Night, and even basically a good amount of Christmas songs and a lot of holy songs as well. But I really have to say that throughout the moments I've been listening to this album on Spotify, I did spot a couple of highlights. I really love the Cantique du Noël or Minuit Chrétien or O Holy Night, sung in both French and English. That rendition really brings me to tears, and it definitely leaves a very strong impression on me. I've seen the music video on YouTube. It has left me with tears, and I listen to that every time on the holidays. It's definitely a very stirring rendition of a Christmas classic, and one I really enjoy to this very day. It really stirs my heart, and it really leaves me very much breathless. But I have to say that the hugest highlight is definitely Juan Diego Flores' original song, Santo, in which he also composed this song, and I think he also wrote the lyrics. Interestingly enough, this song was not only sung in Spanish, but also in a Peruvian dialect, which I found very, very great because it also ventured into his Peruvian roots. So this was the biggest highlight of the album. There was no doubt that I really loved him in a lot of the mass excerpts like the Rossini one and also César Franck's Panis Angelicus. But I really have to say that the biggest highlights for me were without a doubt O Holy Night or Minuit Chrétien and Santo. With that said, I give Juan Diego Flores Santo a well-deserved 5 out of 5 stars. This is definitely a very great album to listen to probably throughout the holidays, as I could also recommend it. But you could also listen to it even if it's no longer the holidays. Whether you listen to the holidays or not, it's definitely worth it, especially if you are a hardcore Juan Diego Flores fan. I really do appreciate his voice. I really do appreciate a lot of his talent. I really do appreciate just how clean and accurate his voice is. And this album was definitely one of the finest testaments ever. Well, that's it for this review of Juan Diego Flores Santo. Stay tuned for my review of Edita Gruberova Christmas Recital. Stay tuned for that.